Bonnecary Spillway was open and we've seen all those damages on the coast. This isn't just going to impact the state fisheries. This will also impact the federal fisheries. And I'm going to tell you how. When all that was going on, we fish, refish, so we have to go way out. Right. Part of what we have to do is catch our live bait near shore and then travel offshore to go catch our targeted species for the day. What was happening, instead of going right out the back and catching my bait, or right out on the east side and catching my bait and then coming around the west side, you know, or going on that side to fish, I couldn't fish on that side. So I had to go clear across there to catch the bait. David and I go all the way around the mouth of the Mississippi River to keep it live, and then go all the way out to the west side to catch the targeted fish for that season. So this is not, you know, when you have an influx of this polluted, we keep calling it freshwater diversions, but it's polluted river water, let's call it what it is, and you dump this into these estuaries, not only is it going to impact shrimp and oysters and crab, this is also going to impact finfish, which is also going to impact our recreational sector. So, I mean, look, I just took my captain's course and getting my license, and what am I doing? I'm going to sell my commercial boats and get into the recreational sector, and then guess what's going to happen? Here come y'all with the diversion. So my question is back to what I asked earlier, and I'm not saying I want this because I don't, but the mitigation money, what's your plan? If I can't make money living here doing what I'm doing right now, I don't want you training.
Yeah.
I don't want it. If I wanted to go to college, I'll go sign up on my own and do that all by myself. I'm a big girl.
Yeah.
What I want to know is if I can't live here and make a living, are y'all, not y'all personally, but the CPRA, is the CPRA prepared, if you're going to wipe out our way of living in South Plaquemines Parish, to come into South Plaquemines Parish and buy everything that we got, not just a boat, not a net, don't buy me a freezer. If I can't make a living with what I'm doing right now, I don't want to be here. You understand what I'm saying? I came home because I fish for a living. My husband fishes for a living. This is what I love. This is what I do. So is the CPRA, I'm going to please it, yes or no? Is the CPRA prepared to come and buy my home and every inch of equipment that I had and help me move if I can't make a living here?
So
that's what I want to know.
So no, that's not been contemplated right now.
Exactly.
I'm glad you came back around.
Why are we upset?
Well, so I'm glad you brought that back up, actually, and I was going to come back around to you and ask you, is it either do that or nothing, no project, or you buying everything?
It's not up to me. I'm asking how I'm going to survive. What y'all do with our estuary obviously isn't up to us, because we wouldn't be having this conversation about a diversion still today. Let's be clear about that. It's not about us or nothing. What I'm asking is, how am I going to survive this? How are me and my colleagues going to survive this, especially people of minority groups? Our Asian community here, there's a huge language barrier. They didn't leave their home to come here. They left their whole country, their language, their culture, everything they knew to come here and build a life. And let me tell you what, they're awesome people. Some of the most wonderful people, most honorable people, hardest working people you will ever come across in a great community. What are they going to do if we can't make a living? The CPRA, as you said, is not prepared to come in and buy us completely out. So what does that leave us? A lawsuit with the state, then they pass legislation where we can't sue the state, right, for damages due to coastal restoration. Is that correct?
I don't know.
And then Garrett Graves goes to the federal level with the Magnuson-Stevens Reauthorization Act and tries to change the definition of the essential fish protection, habitat protection law, so y'all can get this project built, which Chip Klein wrote a letter to support.
That wasn't for this project.
That absolutely was for this project.
It was not.
There's a video of it for the coastal restoration.
That was for levy work, actually.
This project has been evaluated on the essential fish. Everything is
attacked on there. That's
why are they trying to change the definition?
That reference is a request of levy board associations.